ट्रक्शन कन्वर्टर कैबिनेट। Let us understand the DC link block diagram before we discuss the TCC. The 2600 volt DC link voltage is traveling in two wires, one is positive and the other is negative, and the dynamic grid comes into picture when dynamic brakes are applied. DC link before entering to the traction inverters or traction computers, it crosses through a primary safety device called brake chopper. This brake chopper consists of a IGBT, a freewheeling diode and a resistance across the DC link voltage wires. If the voltage is more than 2600 volts but less than 2800 volt, this brake chopper comes into picture and a supply comes from the loco control computer to this gate, and the IGBT is on. Now this resistance starts conducting and the excess voltage is dropped through this resistance and only 2650 volt passes through it. After this, if the voltage is yet high, more than 2800 voltage, then there comes in picture a secondary safety device called crowbar. This crowbar fires in two ways. One is soft crowbar firing and one is hard crowbar firing. This is a resistance of 2.94 ohm. Two resistances parallel in connection. Resultant resistance is 1.49 ohms. Now, if the voltage is more than 2800 and less than 3400 volt, then from LCC, loco control computer, supply comes to this SCR gate. This is SCR. As soon as SCR gate is supplied with voltage, the SCR starts conducting and the excess voltage drops in this resistance and travels 2650 volt further. Now, if the voltage is more than 3400, then this is fired, but not through LCC, but through a hardware circuit of this SCR gate. That firing is called hard firing of crowbar. However, whenever crowbar fires, the driver has to shut down the loco and restart the loco so that the latched condition of SCR is reset. But in case of IGBT, we don't need to shut down the loco and restart, because this after firing does not go to latching. Now see, this 2650 volt will travel further if it is 3600 or more. Then this voltage comes here and there is a contactor, DC link contactor. This is negative side and this is positive side. When this contactor picks up, then only this DC link voltage further passes to through this capacitor unit, and here it filters the ripples of DC voltage. Now it enters the traction inverter number 1, similarly in other 5 traction inverters also, and this traction inverter converts this DC voltage into 3-phase AC, and this 3-phase AC is supplied to the field of the traction motor, and the traction motor armature is induced voltage from the rotating field field winding is not rotating, the field created is a rotating field. So this after inducing voltage in the armature, it becomes a current carrying conductor. When a current carrying conductor placed inside the magnetic field and it is rotating, so this will work as a motor, the armature will rotate and motors will work like a motor. Same will be the case with other five motors. This is the traction converter cabinet. The location is in between driver's cab and the clean air room. The clean air room is just beside the generator. This side, left side of the locomotive, you can see traction inverter number 135 are housed here. One brake chopper module is also housed here. And crew bars are here inside. Now 135 computers are here. And inverter blower 135 are here. Similarly, on the further side, right side of the loco, traction computer number 246, traction inverter number 246, and traction inverter blower number 246 are housed there. From here, the traction motor output terminals have been emanated to undergear for traction motor connection. In this figure, we see the further other side of the TCC on the driver's cab side, where these Harting contactors, where the traction motor sensors, speed sensor, temperature sensor cables are coming in Wago connectors and connected here. Let us understand the three-phase conversion of DC voltage. In the phase modules, here we see there are three phase modules: U phase, B phase, and W phase module. Each phase module contains two IGBTs with two freewheeling diode. See, three phase modules. Now each phase module converts the DC voltage into a AC phase voltage. So these three phase modules converts this DC voltage into three phase AC, and it is fed to the traction motor field. The field is connected in star connection. When you supply the three phase AC to the field of the traction motor, this field winding will create a field in which the magnetic poles NS NS will be rotating. This magnetic field is of rotating nature. These are DC link contactors. See, only one DC link contactor in this figure. These are motor operated contactors. There are total 6 DC link contactors, one each provided for one traction inverter. The DC link contactor has one positive side and one on the negative side. Any one of the contactors can be operated independently. That means if needed, any one of the traction inverter can be dummied, that is, the motor can be dummied associated with the inverter. Each contactor has positive and negative terminals at input and output ends. These contactors are used to isolate particular traction inverter from main DC link through either display or from here through DC link switches. But the system opens when the voltage between DC link contactors is less than 50 volt. So how we can reach from 2600 volt to 50 volt? This can be done by this switch, isolation switch. If you bring this switch to isolate position, it is a spring loaded switch, then the 2600 volt is discharged through DC dynamic braking grids and only 50 volts remains there. So first we bring this switch to isolate position, then we isolate the motor we want to isolate by either from display or from this DC link breakers, circuit breakers placed in ECC 1 cabinet. Now these are the capacitors. As I discussed, these capacitors just filter the ripples of DC. Total 6 DC link capacitors are provided, each one for one traction inverter. Now these capacitors are provided to reduce DC link voltage ripple, as I already discussed. Temperature of each DC link capacitor is monitored by respective traction computers through temperature sensor PT100. If the temperature rises above 68 degree centigrade, the traction computer will reduce the torque of the particular traction motor. If the temperature further rises beyond 75 degree centigrade, then the traction computer will cut off the traction inverter and thereby isolate the motor. As I discussed, this is the traction inverter number 1, 3 and 5 phase modules, UBW phase modules. And this is brake chopper module. These are the traction inverter blowers and these are the traction computers. Same labeled here as for ease of understanding. Now each inverter is comprised of 3 IGBT phase modules, what we have seen in the last slide. Each phase module contains 2 IGBTs and traction computer sends the firing signal through optical fiber cable to individual IGBT gate, through gate drive cards to control the traction inverter output. Each IGBT gate drive card has an independent power supply and the health of the power supply is monitored by traction computer concerned. Each module has 2 temperature sensors to monitor the temperatures of 2 IGBTs individually. Now, if the temperatures are monitored by traction computer, the traction computer will take necessary step when temperature rises above 80 degree centigrade, the torque of the respective traction motor will be derated. When the temperature further rises above 85 degree centigrade, the respective traction inverter will be cut off, that is, the respective motor will be isolated. This is one further view of inside of the TCC. These are the inverters, ABB inverters for blowers. And these are the boosters. I will discuss just See, the booster and ABB inverter arrangement for traction inverter blower motor. The CA output is 40 to 240 volts, CA companion alternator. AC. Now, this is not sufficient to drive the AC inverter, AC blower motor of traction inverter. So, this voltage is rectified in a bridge rectifier, and from here this DC voltage goes to a booster because this was insufficient to run this blower motor. So this booster boosts this DC voltage to 330 volt DC, and this 330 volt DC goes to a inverter. This is called ABB inverter, blower inverter. From here it is converted into three phase AC and it goes to traction inverter blower motors. Now blower motor speeds are controlled in three different speeds depending upon the temperature of the cabinet. So the blower inverter is controlled by a TC, traction computer, where its frequency is governed by this traction computer, and it gives three phase AC of three different frequencies. When there is need of low speed, we use 30 hertz three phase AC. When medium speed is needed, we use 40 hertz three phase AC, and when high speed is needed, we use 50 hertz three phase AC for the inverter blower motor. Now each inverter, traction inverter, has three IGBT phase modules and is provided with one blower motor. The blower motor is controlled by respective TC through booster and ABB inverters assembly. The speed of the blower motor is controlled in three different levels depending on the temperature of the phase module. The speed is low speed, medium speed, high speed, as I discussed earlier. This is the booster and this is the ABB inverter. Now we will discuss traction computer. We will discuss one traction computer. There are six computers. So on each side you have seen there are three computers. Here we see traction computer number 1, traction computer number 3, and traction computer number 5, along with two extra cards common to all three computers. So we can say one cabinet, one side cabinet comprises of three computers and one common DIO and communication card. Each computer consists of, see, five modules, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. So we'll discuss these five modules that will complete our TCC. Traction control cabinet, what I was discussing, has six traction computers put into two cabinets on either side. Three traction computers, one DIO card and one communication card in common comprises one side cabinet. Each traction computer cabinet controls three traction inverters and three traction motors. These are the cards. First one is MTCPS, Medha Traction Computer Power Supply Card. Simply it is called Power Supply Card. The second one is Medha Traction Motor Optical Fiber Cable Card, or simply it is called Optical Fiber Cable IGBT Control Card. Third one is Medha Traction Computer Card. This is the main card, this is the brain of the TC. Simply it is called computer card. Then two input cards are there, TC MAIP 10H1. This is analog input card 1. This can handle 10 analog inputs. So this is MAIP 10H1. Similar card 1 is there, TC MAIP 10H2. This also can handle different 10 analog inputs. Now let us understand this figure, that is communication between different modules of traction computer. Here we see all the red lines are showing optical fiber cable communication lines. So what we see from main loco control computer, in the main loco control computer there is a control card, like MTCC is a main control card here, the brain of the traction computer. Main loco computer brain is loco control card that has got two parts. One is main loco control card and the other is auxiliary control card. So it also has two, main and auxiliary, two parts, MTC and ATC. Now through optical fiber communication card, this TC is communicating with this main computer, main loco control computer. So to avoid unnecessary failure, we have got two paths. One is main, one is redundant. Here also one is main, one is redundant. That means if one path fails, the other path will continue in the communication and loco will not fail. Now MTCC main control card gets feedback from this optical fiber card and gives feedback through this optical fiber card to the main loco control computer. It communicates with traction, Medha traction motor optical fiber card to get the IGBT phase module requirements for traction motors and to fire the IGBT gates from here. So these communications are through optical fiber cable. Now this is fed with other analog data through voltage, current, temperature, pressure, etc. through different sensors, through these two input cards, MAIPTN1 and MAIPTN2. And two digital input output communication cards and these two are common for one side, three computers. So these common cards communicate with main traction computer card 135 and 246 so that the digital input is fed to the computer and any output from the computer digitally is taken from this, and then this further communicates to the user. There is a card, power supply card, that I was discussing. This card has function from 74 volt of battery supply. It converts the 74 volt into 15 volt supply and 9 volt supply. One thing is ensured in this: when starting time only it gets 20 volts, then also it converts it into 15 volt and 9 volt supply. This DIO card, digital input output card, that common card, is communicating with traction inverter, thermal switch, booster inverter, heating connector, etc. Different sensor gives digital input to the MTCC through this input output card. Now we will discuss one by one card, traction computer card main. It is the heart of the traction converter controlling traction inverter and traction motors. Now this module contains one digital signal processor DSP and one microcontroller. the main traction motor computer TMC contains DSP and the auxiliary traction computer ATC contains the micro computer. Now this module the auxiliary traction computer. This establishes communication between main loco control computer via main optical fiber cable communication channel. It monitors various parameters like IGBT heat sink temperature, DC link capacitor temperature, output voltages, traction motor stator temperature, health of speed signal of traction motor, and output currents through two analog input cards, MAIP101 and MAIP102. It controls the traction inverter lower motor speed based on the temperatures of the traction inverter ID heat sink modules. It monitors the health status of the power supplies and it monitors health of all the gate drive cards of all the IGBT. It has got some LEDs, the condition of which will indicate that what is defective in it. The first LED is external positive supply LED. This should be always on. The second one is system health LED. It normally remains off. If it is defective, then it becomes on. Internal positive supply LED, the third one, should be always on. If it is not on, then the supply is not coming. Internal supply you cannot troubleshoot, the card, the module should be changed. In case of external supply, troubleshooting can be done. Now, this internal negative supply, fourth one is to be always on. This is communication LED. This should always flicker. And if it is on just, does not flicker, that means it has hanged. The loco needs to be reboot or restarted. Now the second last LED, this is for digital signal processor status, and this is a spare LED. This only comes in picture when this communication LED fails and there is one MTCC positive supply LED, last one. This should be always on under healthy condition. If it is off, that means the positive supply is not coming here and the module needs to be changed. Next card or module comes traction computer power supply module. As I have already discussed, this module is a power supply module just like a SMPS in a computer. The SMPS of the computer converts 220 AC supply, 230 AC supply into different voltages for the different modules in the computer. Here this MTCPS card of traction computer similarly converts the power supply of 74 volt from batteries to plus minus 15 volt and plus minus 9 volt and plus minus 13 volt or so as per the need of different modules. Only difference is here it is such designed that when at the time of starting the battery voltage becomes 20 volts, then also it converts the supply into 15 and 9 volts, etc. Traction computer analog input card 1. As I discussed, these cards can handle 10 analog inputs. But here we are having not 10, but we have kept some space for future addition. In process, it will process various signals like 3-phase output currents, line to line voltage of the traction inverters, traction motor stator temperature, traction inverter blower motor, traction inverter input current, all these analog things convert into digital, and the digital data will be fed to the MTCC card because the computer only understands digital data. This module is connected to MTCC card through motherboard, and there is no extra cable which avoids any further failure. These cards also have got LEDs. Simply, these are power supply LEDs, and these should always be on. If they are off, if the power supply from outside is not coming, then we can navigate to see where from the supply has cut. Otherwise, if internal supply is not coming, the module has to be changed. The traction computer analog input card 2 is similar to the analog input card 1, but some other datas are processed here. This module processes temperature signals related to particular traction inverter and converts the signals to levels readable to MTCC, that is, converts into digital signals. This card processes 6 IGBT heat sink module temperature, DC link capacitor temperature. It also provides isolation between signals from sensors and the MTCC card, so that MTCC card is not damaged due to high temperature, due to any high voltage, etc. This module is connected to MTCC card through motherboard of the traction computer cabinet, similarly as MAIP 10-1 card is connected. This has similarly got LEDs for power supply, and these power supply LEDs should always be on in LED. Traction optical fiber card. The function of this module is to convert the analog signal received from the main traction computer card to light signals and vice versa. This light signal travels to the IGBT gate. There it gets converted into again analog signal, voltage signal, and fires the IGBT gate and takes the feedback from there as analog, converts it into light signal, then it travels from all the way in this cable and comes to the MTCC card, and at this end it gets converted into digital signal and fed to the MTCC card. This is the function of this module. The common digital input output card. Function of this card is to take digital signals and give these digital signals to the computer. Now, what are the signals it take? This card is common to 3 TCs, either 135 or 246. This module receives digital inputs required for proper operation of the traction motor computer, like status of the Harting contactor, traction motor speed sensor, RPM sensor are connected through WAGO cables to these Harting contactors. Thermal switches. Each module heat sink has one thermal switch in addition to temperature sensors. These are also connected to this signal MTC DIO card. TI blower inverter. This is also fed to the computer through this MTC DIO card. If the Harting connector is slack or thermal switches are open, then this traction motor computer shuts down the respective inverter for safety. If any card is missing, or not inserted properly, then this digital input output card senses the same and displays a message to the driver display. This has also got three LEDs. On under healthy conditions, heat sink thermal switch LEDs, off when thermal switch opens, and one spare heating connector LED and ABB inverter feedback LED. These are the heating contactors. Here the serial number has been different. This is the serial number, not 135246 but 124 and 356, and it does not require to remember because these are unique. You cannot fit wrongly the other WAGO connector to a which is not its heating connector. This is foolproof arrangement. This is the brake chopper assembly that I already have discussed, and that thing is clearly jotted down here. You can understand if you go through. This is self-explanatory. Same is the case. This is the resistance of brake chopper which is kept inside the clean air room. This value of the resistance is this crowbar assembly location, as I have told earlier, that it is on the upper side of the TCC traction converter cabinet. Actually in Medha Loco this has been removed. They are not using it because they have found that after long time of assessment that the voltage DC link voltage does not go beyond 2800. So they removed this. Their crowbar never fired, but EMD Loco the crowbar is there. Crowbar also I have discussed, and it is self-explanatory as explained here. This is the crowbar resistance. Two resistances of 2.94 ohm in parallel are fitted here. So the effective resistance is 1.47 ohm. Thank you.